Sterilization and disinfection is a very important step in an OT or before proceeding with any procedure. Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental and basic Ayurvedic sciences. और आज के हमारे टॉपिक में हम आपको बताएंगे दैट हाउ कैन यू यूज फिजिकल मेथड्स टू डिसइंफेक्ट एंड स्टेरिलाइज एन ओटी और क्लिनिक. बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू ऑल फॉर योर सपोर्ट. एंड इस चैप्टर के रेडी टू रीड नोट्स अवेलेबल है हमारे इंस्टाग्राम पेज पे, जिसका लिंक गिवन है डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में.
स्टरलाइजेशन एंड डिसइंफेक्शन, सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. And when I talk about sterilization, so it is the process by which, you know, you make any surface, any medium or an article, you make it free from all the microorganisms, either in the vegetative or spore form. Then what is disinfection? Disinfection, it is basically when you destroy all the pathogens or organisms which can produce any infections. So, but not necessarily spores. Now, all the organisms, it is not necessary that all organisms may be killed, but it will be reduced in number, so it will be no longer harmful to the health. Then uses of sterilization or disinfection. So here are some of the uses. Like, it is also used to sterilize, you know, some instruments that you use for surgery and for diagnostic procedures. Then it is used for media and reagents also. Then let us talk about methods of sterilization. So in this video, I would be only discussing about the physical methods of sterilization, as we have two methods of sterilization. One is physical and the other is chemical method. So in this video, I'll be discussing about physical methods, and in my next video, you can see about chemical methods. So all these are the physical methods like heat, ozone, sunlight, then filtration, radiation. Then you can see about the chemical methods. Here I'm just briefing about chemical methods in detail. You can see it in my next video. So first is alcohols, then aldehydes, then we have phenols, halogens, oxidizing agents, salts, dyes, and surface active agents, gases. So all these was about chemical methods. Now we are going to discuss in detail about physical methods. So first physical method, which is sunlight, and it is a very natural method of sterilization in case of any water in tanks, rivers and lakes. So natural method of sterilization. Then second comes your heat. So heat is what? Heat is actually the most, you know, reliable and is a common method for sterilization. So in this heat, heat sterilization, there are two types of heat sterilization. One is dry heat and other is moist heat. So basic principle for this is like dry heat is going to kill all the organisms by, you know, denaturation of bacterial protein, oxidative damage, and by toxic effect of elevated levels of electrolytes. Due to increased level of electrolytes, it also provides toxic effect. Then moist heat, it is going to kill the microorganisms by denaturation and coagulation of proteins. So let's talk about dry heat sterilization. So the following procedures comes incineration. By this method, you know, effective material is reduced to ashes by burning the instrument named as incinerator, and this may be, you know, used for this purpose and like soiled dressings, animal carcasses, and these pathological materials, you know, they are dealt with this method. So it is also one of the methods for treatment and disposal of biomedical waste. Then we talk about hot air oven. So this is like most widely used method hota hai, sterilization by dry heat ka. And isme kya hota hai? The oven is electrically heated, and usme kya hota hai? There is a fan, you know, which is going to ensure adequate and even distribution of hot air in the chamber. So it is also fitted with the thermostat. Isme thermostat bhi hota hai, that is going to maintain the, you know, chamber air at a chosen temperature maintain karne ke liye we have a thermostat also. Now temperature and time, that is 160 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. It is the basically the holding time that is required for sterilization. Then uses of hot air oven, you can see that it is used for chemicals like liquid paraffin fats and sulfonamide powder. Then glassware like glass syringes, petri dishes, pipettes, all these. Then surgical instruments like scalpel, scissors, and forceps. Then what are precautions you must take? So one thing you must ensure that it should not be overloaded. Then the material jo hum de rahe, that it should be arranged in a proper manner. Jisse ki air is circulated in the hole, like it is evenly circulated. Then material to be sterilized, it should be perfectly dry also. Then test tubes, flasks, etc. All these should be, you know, you should fit with the cotton plugs. Then petri dishes and pipettes, they should be wrapped in craft paper. Rubber materials, aap jo bhi use kar rahe ho, except for silicon rubber, if you are using any inflammable material, then should be not kept inside the oven. So the oven must be allowed to cool for 2 hours. Before you are opening the doors, it should be cool for 2 hours. Since the glassware may crack, you know, sudden cooling hogi, so you all know glassware jo hote hain wo crack ho jate hain sudden cooling ki wajah. So make sure that you are allowing it to cool for 2 hours before opening the doors. Then we talk about sterilization control. So basically sterilization control, the spores of toxigenic strain of Clostridium tetani, they are kept inside the oven. Now these spores, they are going to destroy if the sterilization is proper. So make sure that sterilization is proper. Then thermocouples, they also may be used. Then Brownie's tube with green spot is available. So after proper sterilization, kya hoga ki a green color is produced. Then we talk about moist heat sterilization. So basically moist heat sterilization mein kya hoga? This method of sterilization, it may be used at different temperatures. You see, hum bahut sari temperatures pe use kar sakte hain. So like one is that at a temperature below 100 degree Celsius. So below 100 degree, it jo hum kar sakte hain, pasteurization of milk we can do. Two types of method. One is your Holden method, that is 63 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes you have to keep it, and flash method. In this, 72 degrees Celsius would be the temperature for 20 seconds, followed by cooling quickly to 13 degrees Celsius or load. Then you have incipitation. In this, some serum or any egg media, so it, you know, such as Weinstein's or Loftus serum. So these are rendered sterile by heating at 80 to 85 degrees Celsius temperature hota hai for half an hour daily or 3 consecutive days. So 3 consecutive days tak hum ise, we are going to keep it heated at this temperature. Vaccine bath also. So bacterial vaccines, they are going to be sterilized in special vaccine baths. Okay. So at 60 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Can see low temperature steam formaldehyde sterilization hota hai. For this, you know, for items which cannot, you know, jo zyada temperature le nahi sakte, like which cannot withstand temperature of 100 degrees Celsius, unko hum is method se karte hai sterilize. In this method the steam at sub atmospheric pressure at the temperature of 75 degrees Celsius will be there with formaldehyde vapor is used. Then we come to at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. So 100 degrees Celsius pe we all know boiling kar sakte hai, which is for 10 to 30 minutes. So this is going to kill all the vegetative forms, but you know, may spores withstand boiling for a, you know, for some time. it boiling se aap you can sterilize the glass syringes or the rubber stoppers. So it is not recommended for sterilization of instruments used for surgical procedures. Boiling से हम सर्जिकल प्रोसीजर्स के लिए जो हम इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स यूज करते हैं वी डोंट प्रेफर टू स्टरलाइज देम बाय बॉइलिंग. देन टिंडलाइजेशन और इंटरमिटेंट स्टरलाइजेशन. सो स्टीम एट 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस फॉर 20 मिनट्स ऑन 3 सक्सेसिव डेज इज रिड्यूस्ड. दिस इज द प्रोसेस. प्रिंसिपल क्या होगा इसका टिंडलाइजेशन का? दैट द प्रिंसिपल इज दैट द फर्स्ट एक्सपोजर किल्स ऑल द वेजिटेटिव फॉर्म्स. ठीक है. एंड इन द इंटरवल्स बिटवीन द हीटिंग्स द रिमेनिंग स्पोर्स जर्मिनेट इनटू वेजिटेटिव फॉर्म्स. देन ऑन सब्सिक्वेंट किलिंग हीटिंग दे माइट आल्सो बी किल्ड. सो इट इज यूज्ड फॉर स्टरलाइजेशन ऑफ एग और शुगर कंटेनिंग मीडिया है कोई तो विच आर डैमेज्ड एट हायर टेम्परेचर ऑफ ऑटोक्लेव. सो उसके लिए वी यूज दिस steam sterilizer at 100 degree celsius for 90 minutes. This is also used like this. Usually it is used for the media which is, you know, which are decomposed at high temperatures of autoclave. Then you can see at a temperature above 100 degree celsius. So above 100 ke liye water boils when its vapor pressure is equal to that of the surrounding pressure. We all know this. This is the process of boiling. Now, when the atmospheric pressure it is raised, then the boiling temperature is also raised. So, at normal pressure, water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. But when the pressure inside the, you know, that closed vessel, when the pressure inside it will increase, the temperature at which water boils also, that will also increase. So this principle has been applied in autoclave and pressure cooker. So autoclave and pressure cooker I will discuss after this topic. So in that also yahi principle kaam karta hai. Then now we are going to discuss about autoclave. So what is the basic principle of autoclave? Steam above 100 degree Celsius or saturated steam jo hum use karte hain because it has a very better killing power than dry heat. So bacteria are more susceptible to moist heat as bacterial protein is going to coagulate rapidly. Now saturated steam can penetrate porous material very easily. So when steam comes into contact with a cooler surface, then it is going to condenses to water and then liberate its latent heat to that surface. So the large reduction in volume sucks in more steam. से ज्यादा स्टीम सक्शन होगा टू द सेम साइट एंड द प्रोसेस कंटिन्यूज टिल द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द आर्टिकल इज रेज्ड टू दैट ऑफ द स्टीम. द कंडेंस्ड वाटर प्रोड्यूसेस मॉइस्ट कंडीशंस फॉर किलिंग द माइक्रोब्स प्रेजेंट. देन यू कैन सी द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ ऑटोक्लेव. सो व्हाट ऑल कंपोनेंट्स आर देयर? बेसिकली ऑटोक्लेव होता क्या है? इट इज अ मॉडिफाइड प्रेशर कुकर और अ बॉयलर यू कैन से. सो इट हैज अ वर्टिकल और हॉरिजॉन्टल सिलेंडर होता है विच इज मेड अप ऑफ स्टेनलेस स्टील. देन इट हैज अ यू नो लिड इज फास्टन्ड बाय स्क्रू क्लैंप्स एंड रेंडर्ड एयर टाइट. सो इट बिकम्स एयर टाइट बाय एन एस्बेस्टोस वॉश. देन लिड हैज अ डिस्चार्ज टैप फॉर एयर एंड स्टीम. अ प्रेशर गॉज एंड अ सेफ्टी वॉल्व इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट. The steam circulates within the jacket and is supplied under high pressure to the inner chamber where materials are kept for sterilization. So now you can see that what are so in this procedure the cylinder is filled with water and the material to be sterilized you place it on the tray. Then you're going to close that lid with the discharge tap open and the heater is put on. Now safety valve jo hota hai, it is adjusted to the required pressure. Now after boiling of water, the steam and the air mixture is allowed to escape till all the air has been displaced. Then the discharge tap jo hai, hum usse ab close kar denge. Then steam pressure, you know, rises inside. Steam pressure inside that autoclave, it will increase, and when it reaches the desired set level of 15 lbs per square inch, so safety valve opens and the excess steam jo bhi hai, it is going to escape then. From this point, the holding period is continued, that is 15 minutes. Now, after the holding period, kya hoga? Heating hum stop kar denge and the autoclave will be allowed to cool till the pressure gauge indicates that the pressure inside it, it is equal to the atmospheric pressure. So, the discharge cap is open now. Slowly, I'm going to open it and air is allowed to enter the autoclave. So, the lid is now opened and the sterilized material is removed. So, what are the sterilization conditions basically? Temperature is 121 degrees Celsius. Chamber pressure is 15 pounds. Holding time I've told you that is 15 minutes. Then sterilization can also be done at higher temperatures, at 126 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes or 133 degrees Celsius. So now what is the use of sterilization? So it is basically used to sterilize for use of autoclaves to sterilize culture media or any rubber material. And also for those materials which cannot withstand the higher temperatures of hot air room. So uske liye bhi we use autoclaves. And for all the type of glass syringes, hot air oven is a better sterilization method. Glass syringes ke liye we prefer this. Now what are precautions you must take? Ki air jo hai, it should be allowed to escape from the chamber. And materials should be arranged in such a manner. Materials hame aise arrange karne ki andar equal air circulation, heat circulation proper hona chahiye. Sterilization control mein we talk about thermocouple. So thermocouple, it is going to record the temperature. Then bacterial spores, if I talk about, so these spores of Geobacillus stereothermophilus, so they are used as test organism. Yeah, test organism ki tarah use karte hain. The spores of this organism, they are going to be killed by like 12 minutes at 121 degrees Celsius. Now an envelope containing a filter paper strip impregnated with 10 spores is placed inside the autoclave during sterilization. The spores are destroyed, and if sterilizing conditions of autoclave are proper, so properly spores destroy ho jayenge. Now we talk about the chemical indicators. So Brownie's tube contains red solution which turns green when it is exposed to 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. Okay. So, and also there is autoclave tapes. Then we talk about ozone. So ozone may low temperature sterilization by ozone we do. Ozone sterilizer show that it is going to use oxygen, water and electricity, which will produce ozone within the sterilizer and provide sterilization without it producing any toxic chemicals. So it runs at lower temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. This device mein kya hoga, jo oxygen molecules hote hain, hum wo separate ho jate hain into atomic oxygen in the presence of electrical field. Then ye jo atomic oxygen hai, this is going to combine with other oxygen molecules which will form O3, that is ozone. We talk about filtration. Filtration is a common method, so useful hota hai. It is useful for substances jo ki heat wagera se damage ho jate hain, like cera, sugars, the antibiotic solutions. So basically uses you can see for filtration to sterilize cera or sugars or any antibiotic solutions, then separation of toxins and bacteriophages from bacteria. Then to filter any discs which retain the organism which can then be cultured, like any testing of water samples for any typhoid. Okay, then purification of water, it is also used to obtain the bacteria free filtrate of clinical samples for virus isolation jo hum use karte. Types of filters, you can see these earthenware filters. So basically ye hum purification of water ke liye use karte hain, it is made from hollow candles. This earthenware candles jo hai, this is made from hollow candles, and then we pass the liquid that we want to filter through the candle. सो टू टाइप्स की होती हैं इसमें भी. वन इज डायटोमिशियस अर्थ एंड द सेकेंड इज अनग्लेज्ड पोर्सलेन फिल्टर. देन वी टॉक अबाउट एस्बेस्टॉस डिस्क फिल्टर्स. सो दिस इज लाइक अब हम इसे यूज नहीं करते हैं. वी नाउ डेज वी डू यूज इट बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स कार्सिनोजेनिक प्रॉपर्टीज. देन वी हैव सिंटर्ड ग्लास फिल्टर्स. दिस इज यू नो मेड बाय फ्यूजिंग द फाइनली पाउडर्ड ग्लास पार्टिकल्स. जो सिंटर्ड ग्लास फिल्टर्स हैं ये फाइनली पाउडर्ड ग्लास पार्टिकल्स को कंबाइन करके बनते हैं. देन वी टॉक अबाउट द मेम्ब्रेन फिल्टर्स. सो दिस इज लाइक मेड ऑफ सेलुलोज ईस्टर्स. वी यूज इट इन वाटर एनालिसिस. ओके देन एयर फिल्टर्स दैट वी सी. सो दिस इज यूज टू डिलीवर क्लीन बैक्टीरिया फ्री एयर टू एनी रूम और यू नो क्यूबिकल. देन वी हैव रेडिएशन. सो टू टाइप्स ऑफ रेडिएशन आर देयर फॉर स्टेलाइजेशन. वन इज आयनाइजिंग एंड दी अदर इज नॉन आयनाइजिंग. सो आयनाइजिंग रेडिएशन बेसिकली इसमें क्या होता है, गामा रेज, एक्स रेज एंड कॉस्मिक रेज से होता है. सो दे डैमेज द डीएनए बाय वेरियस मैकेनिजम्स. गामा रेडिएशन जो होती है हम कमर्शियली यूज करते हैं फॉर स्टेलाइजेशन ऑफ डिस्पोजेबल आइटम्स सच एज प्लास्टिक सिरिंजेस, स्वैब्स, ओके एंड कैंडलस, ऑल दिस. नाउ दिस मेथड इज नोन एज कोल्ड स्टेलाइजेशन. जिसको कोल्ड स्टेलाइजेशन भी कहते हैं. Then we talk about non-ionizing radiation. So इसमें क्या होता है, infrared and UV rays are involved. Infrared rays जो होती हैं, these are basically for rapid mass sterilization of syringes and catheters. Now UV rays हम use करते हैं for bactericidal activity. Then it acts as a denaturation. It acts by denaturation of bacterial protein. And also it will interfere with DNA replication. Then UV radiation, they are used for disinfecting the enclosed areas. जो भी enclosed areas हैं उनको disinfect करने के लिए use UV radiation. Such as any lab है कोई या any inoculation rooms, laminar flow and operation theatres. In there we use these radiations.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe. Also let us know in the comment box कि ऐसे और कौन से topics हैं जिन पे हम आपके लिए video बना सकते हैं.